As might be expected, given that it's passing through the solar system at breakneck speed, the story of the newly discovered suspected interstellar asteroid A2017 U1 is developing rapidly. Since I made my first report on this object a few days ago, at least 4 more papers have come out characterizing the object and trying to pin down its origin. The first is by Carlos Marcos and Raul Marcos, linked to all papers and materials in the description below for those that wish to dig deep. And it lays out the characteristics of the hyperbolic trajectory of A2017 U1, and strongly bolsters the case that this asteroid is not from the solar system. So where is it from? The second paper is by Eric Gaidos and colleagues, and presents an interesting possibility for the asteroid's origins. I don't think this will ever be pinned down exactly. Objects traveling through space get perturbed by gravitational sources. And trying to reconstruct that past history would be like reconstructing a game of pool, starting with the sinking of the 8-ball. You can get a general idea of how it went by the layout of things, but not much else. They advance an origin for the object in either the Columba or Carina star associations. They suggest that due to the object being devoid of ice, it formed in the inner regions of a protoplanetary disk around one of the stars in those associations, and then was ejected about 40 million years ago by a planet in the system. They go on to predict that we may see future asteroids of this nature coming from the same direction. But how often can we expect to see such objects in the future? In a third paper by David Trilling and colleagues, they calculate the probability of seeing an object like this pass through the solar system. It turns out they are probably pretty common, and we should detect about 0.2 objects per year, which could increase to 1 per year when the Large Synoptic Survey Telescope comes online, which is uniquely suited for detecting objects of this nature. The last paper by Matthew Knight and colleagues constrains the rotation of the object, which is at least 5 hours. They also note that they saw no evidence of a coma when they observed it, further indicating that this is an asteroid, not a comet. That brings up another aspect of this object. It's really red. That makes it difficult to study as far as composition, unfortunately. But it's also consistent with both a primitive object, which you would expect if it formed directly from a protoplanetary disk, and an object that's been traveling through the interstellar medium for a long time, exposed to cosmic rays. While we probably won't ever know too much about this particular object and its history, it opens up the possibility for a future specialization in science a bit sooner than we anticipated: interstellar geology. If indeed objects from other star systems pass through more or less once a year, there will come a time when we may be able to get samples from many of these objects and directly study materials from other star systems. In other words, we do not need to wait for interstellar space travel to get our hands on some exorocks. As it turns out, they also come to us. Thanks for listening. I am science fiction author and futurist John Michael Godier, currently pondering how many times Earth has been smacked by an exorock. 4.5 billion years, you know it's probably happened. I'm not sure how I feel about that, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.